Hi, this is Simon, and this is an introduction to pure data. What I'm going to build today is a pure data program that sends messages to a synthesizer. This is pure data here. What I'm going to be using to make my sound is this micro prism. This is a free download from Native Instruments. Here I have my keyboard plugged in. Here's what it sounds like. I think I just took this Kalimba preset and maybe tweaked a few of the knobs here to get that sound. I'm just going to quickly check in the audio MIDI settings of Reaktor here. I'm going to go over to MIDI. You can see I've got a lot of different input options here, but what's important is this Reaktor 6 virtual input is set to on. If you're using Kontakt, there's a similar switch here. If you're using an external synthesizer, we can use that too. You don't need to do anything in the software. Jumping over to Pure Data. Now let's check the Pure Data options. I go to Preferences, MIDI. Input devices, it doesn't matter for today. We're not going to be doing any MIDI input, but what we're going to be doing is we're going to be sending our MIDI out to that virtual input. If you see, I, again, have a lot of options here. I have some very old external synths that I could run this to. Here's my Pakurana. I could run things to Kima as well. But for today, we'll set it to the Reaktor. So now, again, Pure Data is sending MIDI out to the Reaktor 6 virtual input. And Reaktor is listening for inputs on that Reaktor 6 virtual input. So we're all set for that connection. Now we just need to send some information. This is my pure data window. What I'll start by doing is make a new patch here. I could do this with Command N, but I'll do things through the menus today. What we're going to use to send these MIDI notes out is a noteout object. So let me go put object. You can see I can do command one to put these down. Let me put this out and then write in noteout. What this allows me to do, as you can guess from the name, is send MIDI notes out of Pure Data. In order to send those MIDI notes out, I need something that's going to make a note too. So again, put or command one. Oops, it's over there. Think. Make note. I'm going to wire this first outlet to the first inlet here, and the second outlet to the second inlet here. If you ever don't know what an object does in Pure Data, you can right click, or if you're using a touchpad, control click, and go help. And this will open up the help file about it. So we're just looking at this make note for the moment. A make note takes in pitches here. Again, these are in MIDI note numbers, 0 to 127. It takes in a velocity here, and it takes in a duration in milliseconds in the third one. So let's set that up. Put, this time we'll put down a message because we're going to send numbers as a message. That one's going to be for the note number. The next one's going to be for the velocity. This one's for the duration. Wire them all up. I often do 60 just to start. 60 is middle C in MIDI pitches. For velocity, let's make it good and loud. Let's do 100, right? Remember, maximum being 127. And let's make it a second. 1,000 makes a second because this is the duration in milliseconds, right? And so 1,000 milliseconds makes a second. Now go Command E. You'll notice when I hit Command E, it sends it from edit back to the play mode here. I can click on those. Hey, and we've got a note. Okay, nothing too interesting yet, but let's go here. I'm going to select that. Command D for duplicate. And then I could maybe make this 62. So those adept at MIDI will know that that's a whole step up. So this will be the D above middle C. So let's check that. Command E to lock it down. So far, so good. This is good if I want to have some sort of virtual keyboard or interactive thing that I click on the screen for. But let's make something that plays the notes automatically. Command E to get back to edit, delete my 62, just to 60. Let's make something that automatically triggers this note. So I'm going to go Command 1 this time. Again, that's the same as putting down an object. And this time I'm going to make an object called Metro. Metro is a metronome that clicks at a given interval of milliseconds. So if we want it to click every 200 milliseconds, 0.2 seconds, I can set that up. I'm also going to put a bang here. This isn't strictly necessary, but what this will do is it'll show me when that metronome is banging. And then last, I'm going to add a toggle. And what this toggle is going to do is let me turn off and on that metronome. So let's give this a try. Okay, that's kind of neat. Let's bring that down 2 octaves. It takes a while to ring out. Maybe I'll go here and turn down this echo a hair. But so now we've got something that automatically plays those notes for us. What's happening is I turn on the metro, and then once every 200 milliseconds, it sends a bang. That bang triggers this 36. And then this make note makes a note with note number 36. Again, 2 octaves below middle C, a velocity of 100, and a duration of 1000. I don't think it matters for our kalimba, but if we're triggering every 200 milliseconds, we might shorten that note up a little bit. Just quickly to help us see what's what. Comments don't do anything, but they let us write in labels that show us what's going on. This can be extremely important for when we're getting started. And also, if you ever make a patch that you come back to several years later, the more comments you have, the more likely you are to be able to make something useful out of it. Maybe dial back that velocity of hair. Still pretty loud. It's bassy. Okay, so that's kind of neat. We've got something that will repeat a note for us again and again and again. Let's make something that will choose a random note for us. So what I'm going to do now is add a new object, Command 1. This one I'm going to call random. Random chooses a number between 0 and 1 less than the number I put in. So for example, if I put in the number 6, it's going to choose a random number between 0 and 5. It's going to choose that random number every time it gets sent a bang. So I'm going to wire up the bang to this, right? So now every 200 milliseconds, this is going to pick a random number. I'm going to go to put here, and I'm going to take a number. What this now allows me to do is see what number is coming out of that. So this is different than the message here. This message generally doesn't change. This number is going to show us things as they change. So I've set that going. If we look there, we can see that our random number is changing with each one. Okay, that's pretty neat. But if I just take this, turn that off. If I just take this and run it into my make note, I'm going to get a mess. The reason for that being, what I'm doing then is I'm just sending a note number between 0 and 5. Let's listen just for fun. Okay, that's not unexciting, but that's a whole bunch of mud. What we want to do instead is maybe we could use this choosing a random number from 0 to 5 to select given notes. This will take a little bit more work, but it's going to be worth it. Command 1. I'm going to put cell. Cell stands for select. Cell takes in a number and then sends bangs out of a given outlet. So let me demonstrate that. So cell 0, 1, 2, whoops, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm not putting 6 in there because this random number will never show 6. And so what's going to happen now, I'm going to take this bang here and duplicate it. Move it down. What happens now is this cell takes in the random number between 0 and 5, and then it routes it out to the input that matches. So when it matches 0, it's going to send a bang out here. When it matches 1 here, I'm not going to line these up terribly nicely. Pardon me as I go a bit quicker here. Oops. It's a mistake. Pink. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is 6 numbers. One more. Okay, now let's check what happens now. That's pretty. We could change those to different colors, but let's kick that down the road for a second. It would look very nice. So now we've got random bangs being sent to different places, but we need those bangs to trigger a note number. So what we're going to need to do is put messages under these that we can then send into the make note. So let me stop this. By the way, you'll notice that I haven't been switching off edit mode to activate this. If you've been trying to do this, you'll notice that you can't do it unless you're holding down command. I'm on a Mac. I'm holding down command as I do this. And that allows you to interact with things without locking it down. It's probably best practice to be locking it down, but I'll leave that alone for the moment. Okay, so I'm just going to take this velocity for the moment and duplicate it out. So maybe you don't have any idea what numbers to put in here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a pentatonic scale. I mean, I've got 6 triggers that allows me to do the pentatonic scale and then go repeat the note an octave above. If you don't know your MIDI numbers so well, that's fine. Could be worthwhile thing to look into. For now, we'll keep moving. I'm doing a kind of major anhemitonic scale. Anhemitonic means there are no half steps in it. 64 is the E above middle C. Let's make this the G above middle C, which is going to be 67. And then A, and then the octave above that C. C, D, E, G, A, C. Wire them up. And it's good practice to get these lines straight, but I'll do that in a moment. And then I'm going to select them all, and then I can actually just run them here. Bink. Okay, that's a bit of a mess. Let's move this over just so we can see a little bit better. Now, if I send bangs to these individual spots, that sounds pretty good. So I can bang these manually, but our whole point of doing this metro and the random thing was to allow us to automate it. So let's check this out. That's pretty neat. Let's set this metro way slower, and then we can maybe have this meditative type of thing. What, I don't know, 500 milliseconds? That might still be too fast. Yeah, that's too fast. Let's 750. We'll set that going. I'm going to go back to Reaktor for a second. Where'd I hide that? Over here. Again, going back to my metro. 1250. So that's 1.25 milliseconds. That's too slow. That's not exciting enough. 955, just so it's a weird number. So there we go. That's selecting random numbers and playing. It's selecting a random number 0 to 5 and then choosing a MIDI note based on that number. Okay, well, let's see what we can do here. Mm-hmm. You can really hear how short the note is on that one. Let's go to this duration and let's match this to our clicks. And there we go. Here's the PD patch I started this video with, which is essentially what we just built, but taken to the next level. Let's follow this flow. Here's an on-off switch, which turns on the metro that clicks every 100 milliseconds, chooses a random number 0 to 9. Based on that, I have a whole bunch of note numbers to trigger. These are relatively high, right? Starting at 83, going up to 101. That goes to this make note, which goes to the note out. You'll notice for my velocity and duration, I have this new object, load bang. What this does is when I open the patch, it's like it automatically clicks on these. So I don't have to click to initialize the velocity and duration. This is very useful if you're saving and reopening. Simultaneously with this path, though, there's another metro. This metro is clicking every 6 seconds, so much, much slower than this one. It's choosing a random number between 0 and 2, so 0, 1, 2. And then look at how I've set these up here. I have numbers in a message box that have commas between them. This lets me trigger a chord. The duration of these chords is 6 seconds. So with this single bang, I'm triggering all of those notes at the same time. Of course, I could do separate message boxes with numbers for all of those. I could just spread those out and then wire them back in to the make note. But this can be visually cleaner.